Good morning, students. In 9th standard, last period, we learnt about the point trapezium. And solve the examples of trapezium. We will learn. Then next point is theorem of midpoints of two sides of a triangle. Next point is theorem of midpoints. Theorem of midpoint of two sides. Of a triangle. Theorem of midpoints of two sides of a triangle. Statement is the segment joining midpoints of any two sides. Of a triangle. This parallel to third side and half power of it. Statement of the theorem is the segment joining midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and half of it. That is, firstly, write given in triangle ABC. Point P is, we have to draw triangle ABC. P is a midpoint of AB. And Q is midpoint of AC. Point P is midpoint of segment AB and point Q is midpoint of segment AC. This is given. To prove, we have to prove midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side. That is, PQ parallel to BC. Segment PQ parallel to segment BC and half of it, that is PQ is equal to 1/2 BC. We have to prove these two statements. Then draw one construction. Construction is, produce segment PQ. Up to R such that PQ is equal to QR. Produce segment PQ up to R because then P2 is equal to Q1. Draw segment RC. Draw segment RC. This is the structure. Then proof of the theorem is proof of the theorem. From this construction, two triangles are formed. The triangle APQ and triangle CRQ. Then, in triangle AQP and triangle CQR, triangles are formed. Then, segment PQ formed to segment Q1. This is given in the first structure. PQ is equal to Q1. Next, the second is segment AQ congruent to segment QC. It is given in the statement. Third one is angle AQP. Angle AQP congruent to angle CQR. CQ angle CQR, vertically opposite angle. These two angles are vertically opposite angles. Then from these three statements we have to write triangle AQP congruent to triangle CQR from side angle side test. Then remaining angle, that is angle PAQ congruent to angle RCQ congruent to angle of congruent angle of congruent triangle. This is congruent angle of congruent triangle, and therefore segment AP congruent to segment CR. Equation number 2, this is equation 1, congruent side of congruent triangle. From 1, we write as a line AB parallel to line CR. Alternate angle test. Next, form equation second. Equation second is segment AP congruent to segment CR. Segment AP congruent to segment CR. Then, now, segment AP congruent to segment PB congruent to segment CR. Segment AP congruent to segment PB congruent to segment CR, and segment PB parallel to segment CR. Therefore, ABC, PBCR is parallelogram. Its parallelogram. Therefore, segment PQ parallel to segment BC. PR is equal to BC. PR is equal to BC. Opposite sides are congruent in parallelogram. Therefore, PQ is equal to 1/2 BC. This is Fourier construction. Therefore, PQ is equal to 1/2. PR is equal to BC, then 1/2 BC. This is theorem of midpoints of two sides of a triangle. Then converse of midpoint theorem is statement is, if a line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle and parallel to other side of a, then it bisects the third point. For this theorem, given to prove and construction is given below. Try to write the proof. We have given point is given that point is midpoint of AB of triangle ABC. Line L passing through point D and parallel to side BC. Parallel to side BC intersects side AC in point E. To prove, we have to prove AE is equal to EC. We have given triangle ABC. AB and E is a midpoint of, then this is line L, then take point F on a line L such that D is equal to EF. draw segment CF. Draw segment CF. So please use the construction and line ends parallel to segment BC, which is given to put that. In similar way, triangle AD is congruent to triangle CAP, but side angles are test. We will prove and complete the proof. Then next is example. First example is point E and F are midpoints of A segment AB and segment AC of triangle ABC. EF is equal to 5.6. Then find BC. We have given triangle ABC. EF is midpoint of segment AB, and EF is midpoint of segment AC. Then solution is point E and F are midpoints of segment AB and AC. Then from midpoint theorem we know that BC is equal EF is equal to 1/2 BC. EF we have to give EF is 5.6 is equal to 1/2 BC. 2 is in the order, then we get multiply in right side. This is equal to 2 into 5.6. That is BC is equal to 11.2. BC is 11.2. Next, prove that quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints of a side of a quadrilateral in order is a parallelogram. Second example, prove that quadrilateral formed by joining midpoints of sides of a quadrilateral in order is parallelogram. We have to prove. We have given ABCD is quadrilateral. ABCD is quadrilateral. and PQR, yes, are midpoints of segment A, B, B, C, CD and AD respectively. Then join PQ, RS. To prove that, PQ, RS is parallel. PQ, RS is parallel. Construction draw diagonal CD, draw diagonal BD, this diagonal BD, then so copies in triangle ABD, in triangle ABD, the midpoint of side AD is S. Midpoint of AD is S. And midpoint of slope side AB is midpoint of side AB. Side AB midpoint is P. Therefore, by midpoint theorem, we see the scope of the theorem, then we write as a by theorem, we write ES parallel to BD, ES parallel to BD, and PS is equal to 1/2 BD, equation number first. Then next in triangle DBC, in triangle DBC, similar way Q and R are midpoints of BC and CD respectively. Therefore, by midpoint theorem, QR parallel to BD, QR parallel to BD, and QR is equal to 1/2 BD. Reason is midpoint theorem. Equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, PS parallel to BD and QR parallel to BD, make PS parallel to QR from equation first and second, and PS is equal to QR. Therefore, PS parallel to QR and PS is equal to Q. PS is equal to QR. Then PQRS is parallel. PQRS is parallel. Here our chapter quadrilateral is finished. Then next chapter is circle. We will start in next period. Okay, thank you.